lot to come.
3 years old.
Now I know how Elvis felt.
We're inundated with technology and things that separate us from nature, and I think that perhaps roots music brings us back somewhat to the natural world, because a lot of roots music is an extension of our link with our natural surroundings.
We come from a small community on the western coast of Cape Breton called Mabu. And in the 1800s, around the mid-1800s, most of the people who settled there were of Scottish descent. And they brought their music and traditions with them.
We sing songs that we've heard all our lives. We sing songs that come from where we come from, that are written about events that we would have witnessed, or... I think honesty is important, that we know where we come from, that we're rooted.
The ghost goes out and rags, eyes aglow like embers. When the cold wind blows, embers are a sparkling wind of flame. A burning dead I ride on the blackened timbers. In fearful night, for this day is open, it began. Legend that I can view.
Usually when we do an album, I'll put some pressure on myself to write some original fiddle tunes, and I'll, you know, I'll include that in a medley of tunes.
Quit while we're ahead.
This time around, I just tried my hand at writing, so I had fun doing it, you know. It's fun doing something the first time, and I think there's less pressure on you when you write the first time.
When morning comes to me, she always comes around.
When darkness comes nearer, I see sight. The pen and the letter faded and died. The promise is broken, a change in the time.
I think the healthiest thing about our band and the reason why we've been this successful so far is that we've been allowed to grow. We've allowed ourselves to incorporate different influences in our music, and that's helped us reach different people all across the boards. At times it may seem like we're moving away from our roots a little, but then you have to experiment and you have to grow as a unit in order to survive.
What do you think? A bit loud?
This morning with a feeling.
very much a part of the essence of what we do is the traditional music. And that ranges from the traditional music that John Morris and Howie play with the fiddle and the piano, straight to the Gaelic songs or the traditional folk songs that we sing. I feel that it's very important to maintain that integrity, even if we do develop it and try to incorporate a new style with it. And sometimes I irritate people when I take that stand, because I'm a bit extreme.
I've always noticed how amazing it is that 9 people, you know, can work within this environment with the diversity of the style, because there's so much difference from song to song very often, and it really calls on everybody to dig deep sometimes, and somehow it always comes out working. No matter what happens, it always comes out working.
String that piano.
I mean, everybody strives to do the best that they can do. And when you have 9 people together trying to do their best, you have to leave room for the other guy to do his part.
There's more ways that you could get in the way if you weren't aware of what everybody was playing. So you try to be a little more transparent, fit your fills in between the cracks, and not overplay.
It's what you don't play that is often the most musical statement, because that hole that you're going to leave is what's going to make the next phrase that much more of an impact.
When you cross that river, the trees they will bow down and the love. Your boat's lost at sea.
End of Seasons was a change for us because we wanted a more acoustic approach, a more laid-back approach, a more off-the-floor feel. Sort of like a more immediate sound.
The whole concept of trying to capture tracks more live and not recording to the point that you lose the feel.
You know, we'll take 6 or 7 takes or maybe more of something and go back to the second take or the first take. Because it just, I think there's a couple of songs on this album, on Endless Seasons, that are like that. Where you just, it had that first or second take was the one where everybody was jiving in the same headspace.
Find the water and smoke in the sky. I'll leave a man.
Performing part of this, I really enjoy doing. I enjoy meeting the people and I enjoy working with the people I work with. I truly do. But there's an aspect of me, and every once in a while it emerges. It's, you know, 2 o'clock in the morning and I can't sleep on the bus. And I start to think about that other part of my life that is going on without me. And I get scared. Sure as the sea, sure as the wind is.
after all this time. You're standing at my door.
I carry ideas around in my head for a long time. It may be a story that I've heard, or something I've seen, or a phrase, or just a general concept. At the end of one of these tours, one of these grueling tours, I was coming back from, I think, New York, or coming back from somewhere into Canada. And I just was writing a song about coming back home. And
Jimmy had given me a tape of songs. I think it was in the spring of 90, when I was looking for songs to sing.
I was still working on it when we were doing the pre-production for the North Country album, and it's one of those songs that Heather heard, and she said, I wouldn't mind doing that.
Because he refers to a couple of our granduncles, Danny and Freddie Wright, who worked the log, the River Drive, and I had done a high school project on the River Drive that went from Mull River to Malibu Harbor. And that one caught my ear because of that.
This coming, this emergence of a folk revival, and I very much wanted to be a part of that. I could see that we fit into it because of where we came from, because of what the roots of our music were. I knew that it was going to be a very exciting time.
We decided, well, it's now or never. Either we do it now or we never do it. So we chose to, and it's worked out.
To a lot of people, it seems like, you know, 7 years is a short period of time, and it happened overnight, but we really have been on the road for 7 years.
You know, we have to keep touring, you have to keep doing festivals and producing records. And so a lot of this stuff, although it seems like it happens overnight, it actually doesn't.
We've been very lucky. I think we've had a lot of luck and a lot of good timing. And we've worked hard, too. Has a lot to do with it.
must go. Take your heart, love. Take your heart, love. Will we never meet again no more?
Far across love, far across love, o'er the mountains and country wide, take my heart, love, take my heart, love. No one knows the tears I've cried, so I'm
folks, this is your last chance to dance. I want to see you on your feet. Come on, get up. Lots of room in the aisles. Come on, you guys upstairs too. Let's go. Let's shake some ground in Vancouver. Mr. McDee, oh, the fine shape that he is in. There is no telling which way he'll feel after his twister around the bend. Raising the jar and raising hell, there's plenty of stories that they will tell. Some are poor of true detail and some are purely fiction. Come yonder, it's old McPhee. He's having a few we can hardly see. He wrapped his buggy around a tray. Someone call the Mounties. along the shores of Hagama.
And
racing hounds, plenty of stories that they tell.
Some were born a truly tale and some a purely fiction.
There they stand by the door, suddenly pushed by the storm, asking you to buy some more along the shores of Hagama. I'll go in the morning. I'll go home, full of the devil and full of the rum.